talking. We're going to pretend that she's on the stage.
Turn your attention to the screens. We have a short video.
WIPART and the MasterCard Foundation are partnering together for the Young Africa Works Pre-Summit Youth Session to give the young people some key skills for conferencing, such as networking, critical listening skills, and then also linking them with the wider WIPART network so that when they go back to their home countries, they are youth leaders that can engage with the young people in those countries and work for improving lives of young people in the agricultural sector in those countries.
That session was important for me because it helped me connect with the people in the evening, know how to connect, know how to talk to people.
The workshop helped me to increase my way of understanding how to pitch, but also how to use network to improve my business.
This workshop is like a life lesson. Networking is important for me now and even forever.
But then one of the things that we thought is to actively listen to what the other person is saying and not choose the things that we want to listen to.
You know, it's not easy to approach somebody you've never seen for in your life. So I think that fear was removed in the pre-summit.
We got the opportunity to talk about the things that we're doing, the things that we are passionate about. And it was interesting to find that you do have people also in the group that share the same experience with you.
It was an opportunity for us to share between youth delegates, but also to exercise what you have been learning throughout the webinars and the workshop.
And it was just an exciting moment to see young people come together to help one person to grow, to transform the agricultural sector that she's involved in. So making the most out of the summit is getting to know your speakers very well, and getting to know them is also getting to network with them, getting to know about the experiences, how they started, where they're going, the way forward for agriculture in Africa.
This workshop is very wonderful opportunity to prepare us for the summit. We are young, we are developing, we still want some people to work with us.
It was a very good thing to do, to have a webinar pre-summit, because it made me re-strategize the way I was going to participate in this summit.
The good skill we have here is sharing, which I think I should take back home to share with the youth, because youth are united here and they're sharing their own experiences in the field of agriculture.
Others grow. So my passion in mentoring and also supporting other people is like, I need to give back to other people. And as a person, I feel I've been blessed to at least to have some knowledge and skill which I need to pass on to whoever needs my support.
Perhaps the most powerful way to help people is not even to do anything for them, is to allow yourself to be the example they can learn from. They can learn the things that are probably good to do and the things that are probably not good to do. And that way they open the doors for themselves.
You know, one of the key things for building your career is about the social networks and the know who. I mean, we all say that particularly in sub-Saharan Africa is about who you know and how you get on.
And as far as we are concerned, the top problem they face is the lack of mentorship. It's not the lack of money, although you'll hear that said many, many times. It's not the lack of knowledge, although that also features. It is the lack of a support system, which people who go into a job, for example, take for granted.
This summit is one of the best, giving with the young ones somebody that we can talk to, somebody that we can look up to, even not just after this summit, but post-summit.
We don't need to be together to mentor someone. We don't need to be in one area, in one room, or in one locality to gain experiences from each other.
You are mentored and then you can mentor somebody. It's an experience. He's given me the skills to mentor, that of which if I don't mentor somebody, that means that I've not learned anything.
I can be able to achieve anything I want because I have support and someone who believes in me.
I'm not sure whether I am a mentor to John. He's a mentor to me too. We're learning. There's so much we have to share.
I like with my my brother.
But I think it's a problem of the language.
That's how the workshop was really important to this summit. And today, as you have seen, we are seeing panel, we are going into some breakout sessions, but the way you pitch yourself, you like stand out, expose the problem that you want some people to give the answer. So I've been like having an opportunity to exercise what I've been learning from the workshop.
It gave me courage in the first place so that I can express my ideas and also I can share. So what the workshop did to me was to give me the platform I realized, and it also gave me a chance so that I can ask more sort of information from people that I need to connect with.
This is the first time I've been to a summit where I was made, you know, in quotes, responsible for somebody. And it's a good feeling. I'm not a young man myself anymore. And it feels good that I am able to give something back to somebody in this particular way.
I've also been able to be encouraged by the many young people who have made big companies and are doing great things here in Africa. And that encourages me as I start entering into the same activities.
But my mentor was really, really helpful. The mentorship program really helped me to be able to think through things and be able to ask compelling questions in regards to what's been said.
Now, Alessia and I have got on very well. We've spent a lot of time together. It's not like the normal conference where you're just coming and participating and seeing the same old usual faces. It's given a bit more of a purpose to actually being here.